Welcome to EPG Paathshala. In today's module, we are going to discuss on radiative forcing and global warming with respect to the energy sector. The solar radiation reaching the Earth varies due to orbital changes or change in solar irradiance. The radiative forcing is a change in the Earth's energy balance between incoming solar shortwave radiation and outgoing thermal infrared radiation from the Earth. The albedo of Earth is 30% with the absorption of about 66% of the insolation, that is 19.5 kilocalories per meter square per minute. The irradiance is important in maintaining a constant average temperature on the Earth's surface. The NASA Goddard Institute for Space Studies concluded the variation in solar irradiance that it is around 0.25 watt per meter square. The solar energy absorbed at Earth's surface is 240 watt per meter square, and solar irradiance at Earth's distance from the sun is 1367 watt per meter square. So in this module, we are going to discuss on what is radiative forcing, its types and agents. How the fossil fuel combustion is related to this radiative forcing. What do you mean by this global warming? And how carbon dioxide from energy sector adds to global warming. Let's start with radiative forcing. Radiative forcing is defined as the change in net downward radiative flux at the tropopause after allowing for stratospheric temperatures to readjust to the radiative equilibrium while holding surface and tropospheric temperatures and state variables such as water vapor and cloud cover fixed at the unperturbed values. This is also known as climate force. Recently, assessment report 5, fifth assessment report by the IPCC, they introduced a term ERF, that is effective radiative forcing, which is defined as the change in net top of a atmosphere, that is TOA, downward radiative flux after allowing for atmospheric temperatures, water vapor and clouds to adjust but with surface temperature or a portion of surface conditions unchanged. It is a change of net radiative flux at the top of atmosphere due to natural or anthropogenic causes with potential to alter global temperature. The radiative forcing is the net downward radiative flux at the surface or at some level in the atmosphere, usually at the top of the atmosphere or at tropopause. It is measured as watt per square meter. And the delta F is equal to F net perturbed TOA minus F net clean TOA. What are the different types of radiative forcing? The radiative forcing can be of natural radiative forcing or anthropogenic radiative forcing. Natural radiative forcing. The natural change in solar radiation incident on the Earth is natural climate forcing. It is due to natural disturbances such as volcanic eruptions, solar variability or changes in Earth orbital parameters. So it is without any direct or indirect human interference. The radiative forcing from naturally induced radiative forcing agents is always equal to solar irradiance. Solar irradiance has a radiative forcing value of 0.12 watt per meter square that ranges from 0.06 to 0.3 watt per meter square. And here, the volcanic aerosols in the atmosphere are currently negligible, which contributes to this natural radiative forcing. The second type is anthropogenic radiative forcing. It is due to the human activities such as fossil fuel burning. It is also known as human-induced forcing. The positive radiative forcing increases the temperature or cause warming effect, while negative radiative forcing reduces the temperature or cause cooling effect. It is related to the Earth's energy budget when humans are considered as a factor to the Earth's climate system. This graph shows the radiative forcing of climate between the 1750 to 2011. In this graph, you can see there are different components, natural and human activities, from human activities from the human activities, the long-lived greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, methane, halogenated gases, nitrous oxide, and short-lived gases, aerosols, all these are contributed by the human activities. While natural radiative forcing are mainly due to the change in the energy from the sun and also volcanic eruptions. The positive radiative forcing increases the temperature. You can see in this graph, there is positive and negative values. So the positive radiative forcing means increase in the temperature or it causes the warming effect. While the negative ones, you can see the negative ones are mostly the changes in the clouds due to aerosols, and the aerosols, these and short-lived gases that creates ozone or create or destroy other greenhouse gas, which is represented in the blue color, it has a negative radiative forcing and that reduces the temperature or it causes the cooling effect. It is related to Earth's energy budget. Earth's energy budget. The solar energy undergoes three mechanisms while reaching the Earth's surface: absorption, reflection, and scattering. The Earth's surface absorbs a total of 51% of solar radiation, of which 28% is direct radiation, while 25% is from diffuse radiation. The albedo of Earth is 30%, which includes the 20 from the cloud reflection, 6 from scattering, and 4 from surface reflection. The solar spectrum incident on the Earth's surface has a peak at 483 nanometer, indicating the surface temperature of the sun as approximately 6000 Kelvin. The Earth spectrum shows a peak of about 10,000 nanometer with surface temperature of the Earth about 290 Kelvin. In other words, the Earth absorbs radiation mainly in the visible region but emits radiation at the same rate in the infrared region, that is 2 to 40 micrometer with a maximum at 10 micrometer. The average surface temperature of the Earth is maintained around 15 degrees Celsius due to reabsorption of most of the outgoing infrared radiation by water vapor and to a lesser extent by carbon dioxide. The combined effect of water vapor and carbon dioxide leads to the greenhouse effect, which is of great significance in governing the climate on Earth. Now we will see what are the radiative forcing agents. Natural as well as anthropogenic emission of greenhouse gases is responsible for the gaseous radiative forcing. The greenhouse gases absorb solar radiation of 6000 to 15000 micrometer depending upon the nature of greenhouse gas. The agents of radiative forcing are, we have already seen in the previous figure, these are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and chlorofluorocarbons, tropospheric ozone and atmospheric aerosols. The greenhouse gases are the major radiative forcing agents which cause positive radiative forcing. The aerosol has a negative radiative forcing and the net anthropogenic radiation forcing components adds to a positive radiative forcing or a warming climate. You can see the radiative forcing from this figure, what are the different various or what are the different radiative forcing agents. In this figure, you can see various radiative forcing components. And this table shows the radiative forcing of various greenhouse gases. Carbon dioxide has a range of radiative forcing of 1.49 to 1.83 with an average radiative forcing of 1.66 watt per meter square. Methane has radiative forcing range of 0.43 to 0.53 with an average of 0.48 watt per meter square. Nitrous oxide has a range of 0.14 to 0.18 with an average RF of 0.16. Halocarbon gases has a range of 0.31 to 0.37 with an average RF of 0.34. And the tropospheric ozone has a RF range of 0.25 to 0.65 with an average of radiative forcing 0.35 watt per meter square. Carbon dioxide is the most important climate forcing agent that causes an increased forcing of about 1.66 watt per meter square. The consumption of fossil fuel is increasing day by day and its contribution of carbon dioxide also continue and increase the CO2 climate forcing. The aerosols possess a negative RF value. The aerosols have average RF value of negative 0.5 watt per meter square with a range of 0.9 to 0.1 watt per meter square from the reflection or absorption of solar and infrared radiation. The aerosols also cause cloud albedo effects with an average of negative 0.7 watt per meter square, and the range is minus 1.8 to minus 0.3 watt per meter square. The total net anthropogenic radiative forcing is equal to the average value of 1.6 watt per meter square with an average 0.6 to 2.4 watt per meter square. So this positive value means that the radiation force, the radiative forcing has the effect of warming on the climate. Now we will see what is global warming. For that we should know what is greenhouse effect. The earth is heated both when reduced carbon is oxidized to carbon dioxide and when outgoing long wave radiation is trapped by the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The greenhouse effect is a natural process that warms the earth's surface. When the sun's short wave radiation reaches the earth's atmosphere, some of it is reflected back to space and the rest is absorbed and re-radiated by greenhouse gases. Earth's greenhouse effect is a natural occurrence that helps to regulate the temperature of our planet. When the sun heats the earth, some of this heat escapes back to space. The rest of the heat, also known as the infrared radiation, is trapped in the atmosphere by clouds and greenhouse gases such as water vapor and carbon dioxide. Without the natural heat trapping properties of these atmospheric gases, the average surface temperature of the earth would be about 33 degrees Celsius lower than the present 15 degrees Celsius. Natural processes such as solar irradiance variations, variations in the Earth's orbital parameters, and volcanic activity can produce variations in climate. The climate system can also be influenced by changes in the concentration of various gases in the atmosphere, which affect the Earth's absorption of radiation. The Earth naturally absorbs and reflects incoming solar radiation and emits longer wavelength terrestrial radiation back into space. On average, the absorbed solar radiation is balanced by outgoing terrestrial radiation emitted to space. A portion of this terrestrial radiation, though, is itself absorbed by gases in the atmosphere. The energy from this absorbed terrestrial radiation warms the Earth's surface and atmosphere, creating the natural greenhouse effect. With more greenhouse gases released to the atmosphere due to human activity, more infrared radiation will be trapped in the Earth's surface, which contributes to enhanced greenhouse effect. So we have two types of greenhouse effect: natural greenhouse effect and enhanced greenhouse effect. Let's see what is the global warming potential of various greenhouse gases. Global warming refers to the gradual increase observed or projected in global surface temperature as one of the consequences of radiative forcing, which is caused by anthropogenic emission. According to IPCC, that is Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, global warming potential is an index describing the radiative characteristics of well-mixed greenhouse gases that represent the combined effect of the differing times these gases remain in the atmosphere and their relative effectiveness in absorbing outgoing infrared radiation. This index approximates the time-integrated warming effect of a unit mass of a given greenhouse gas in today's atmosphere relative to that of carbon dioxide. In this table, you can see the global warming potential of various greenhouse gases. You can see the time horizon is 10 years, and carbon dioxide, we are taking it as a reference gas, and compared to that, methane, as per fourth IPCC assessment report, it has 21 times global warming potential in comparison to CO2. Nitrous oxide has 310 times higher than carbon dioxide. Chlorofluorocarbon is in the range of 4,700 to 14,400, while sulfur hexafluoride has a GWP of 22,800. In the fifth assessment report, it has slightly increased or decreased with various gases. In the case of methane, it has increased to 28 times. In nitrous oxide, it has found 265, it has reported as 265 GWP comparison to CO2. And CFCs has 4,660 to 13,900 GWP. Sulfur hexafluoride has 23,500 times higher than that of the carbon dioxide. So you can see that GWP of sulfur hexafluoride is higher than CFC, which is higher than nitrous oxide, which is higher than methane and carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a natural gas and has global warming potential 1, and we have taken it as the reference. The anthropogenic greenhouse gases like CFCs, we have seen it has a GWP up to 10,000, and methane, nitrous oxide and SF6 having GWP 25 to 310 and 23,000 respectively as per fourth assessment report. The IPCC special report on emission scenarios projected an increase in temperature of about 0.2 degrees Celsius per decade. The duration was 2000 to 2100. Though the concentration of GHGs at 2000 level kept constant, then the increase expected is 0.1 degrees Celsius per decade. The energy production and consumption is a major cause for the emission of greenhouse gases and air pollutants that in turn affect radiation forcing and global warming. Energy sector contribution towards radiative forcing and global warming. The radiative forcing is directly linked with these global warming processes. The fossil fuel consumption and global warming are closely related to each other. It is clear that fossil fuel tremendously increased the emission of greenhouse gases that triggered the global warming. The energy sector may increase over the coming years as projected in the given figure. Greenhouse gases from the fossil fuel combustion. The fossil fuel is a major contributor in energy production. Coal, oil and natural gas are major fossil fuels used in energy sectors. The fossil fuel use has increased from 1800 to an annual output of nearly 10,000 million tons of oil equivalent after industrial revolution. The fossil fuel is the primary energy source, accounting about 80% of total energy, with contribution from oil, coal and natural gas as 32.8% from the oil, 27.2% from the coal and 20.9% from the natural gas. The combustion of fossil fuel results in warming up the environment. The greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide and methane, which are mainly produced by the energy sector. The combustion process of fossil fuels from energy sector release a huge amount of carbon dioxide and it can last for hundreds and hundreds of years. Atmospheric carbon dioxide increase the radiative forcing of about 3.7 watt per meter square for a doubling of the carbon dioxide concentration. The global greenhouse gas emissions. The global contribution of different greenhouse gases are given in the figure. The dominant greenhouse gas is carbon dioxide, which account around 76% of the total emissions, of which 65% is from fossil fuel combustion and industrial process. And the contribution of methane from energy sector is around 6%. The global carbon dioxide emissions from fossil fuel combustion and some industrial processes from the various countries are given in the figure. You can see that the China is the major carbon dioxide emitter, followed by United States. And the contribution of India is around 7%. This figure shows the carbon dioxide emission trends from 1971 to 2009 by the fuels, and the highest contribution of carbon dioxide from the fossil fuel combustion is from coal, followed by the oil and the natural gas. The carbon dioxide concentration increased many folds over the last few decades. According to Earth System Research Laboratory, the average Mauna Loa carbon dioxide concentration was 408.35 ppm in February 2018, and in September it was reported as 406 ppm. The sources of fossil fuel combustion, these are electricity and heat generation, the burning of coal, natural gas and oil for electricity and heat is the largest single source of global greenhouse gas emissions. Industry is another source. In industries, the energy for different chemical reactions for the production of goods from the raw materials are attained by burning of fossil fuel. Another sector or the energy source is transportation. It primarily involves fossil fuels burned for road, rail, air and marine conveyance. Almost all of the world's transportation energy comes from petroleum-based fuels. And more specifically, it is from the gasoline and diesel. This sector contributes about 14% of global greenhouse gas emission. The fuel extraction, refining, processing and transportation also contributes to greenhouse gases emission of about 10% of global greenhouse gas emission. Energy supply sector is another source. In this figure, you can see the greenhouse gas emissions from various energy supply sectors like electricity and heat, fuel production, manufacture of solid fuels, petroleum refining, etc. In this figure, you can see the annual carbon dioxide emissions projected for different years. The tropospheric sulfate aerosols produced by the atmospheric oxidation of sulfur dioxide emitted from fossil fuel, combustion, scatter, solar radiation, increasing the clear sky planetary reflectivity that contributes a cooling radiation forcing. What are the mitigation measures for the global warming, that too from the energy sector contribution? Use of energy efficient technologies. The reduction of carbon dioxide emission and efficiency of energy efficient technologies is given in this figure. In this figure, various carbon dioxide emissions and conversion efficiencies of coal and gas-fired power generation and combined heat and power plants are given. You can see in the CHP, that is a combined heat and power generation, the efficiency is higher with least emission of carbon dioxide. This graph shows the greenhouse gas emissions from various electricity generation systems. The energy production from the energy sources, renewable energy sources, such as solar, wind, hydel, biomass, and even nuclear energy. And also you can use fuel cells with hydrogen as fuel and electric cars for the energy sector. And in this figure, the carbon dioxide emissions from various electricity generations are given. And here the renewable energy has less carbon dioxide emission compared to the fossil fuel based energy sectors from where the electricity is produced based on the fossil fuel as the raw material. So we have seen energy production is the dominating source of carbon dioxide emission as well as other greenhouse gases. And approximately 70% of all the anthropogenic greenhouse gas emissions generated from the energy sector, with the largest contribution towards CO2 from the fossil fuel combustion. The increased emission of atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration is mainly due to this fossil fuel combustion. This in turn results in increased long wave radiative forcing of the troposphere that leads to a warming up of the Earth's surface. Thus, global warming and climate change caused by the greenhouse gas emissions are strongly linked to fossil energy production and utilization. So it is very important to shift to more efficient and renewable energy sources to mitigate greenhouse gas emissions from the fossil fuel combustion. And in this module, we have seen radiative forcing, what are its types and what are its agents, and how the fossil fuel combustion is related to radiative forcing. We have seen what is global warming and how the carbon dioxide from energy sector adds to global warming. Thank you.